Taiwan's first private rocket gets permission to launch from South Australia. Australian regulators have given Taiwan Innovative Space Incorporated the green light to conduct a commercial launch at a launch facility in southern Australia later this year. Australia's Minister for Industry, Science and Technology, Christian Porter, welcomes this launch as a landmark for both countries marching into the space commercial market. As Taiwan is being noticed by the world more than ever, and to respond to the nation's bilingual policy, First Commercial Bank is planning to recruit hundreds of bilingual financial consultants by the end of this year with a monthly pay of 45,000 NT dollars. The bank plans to set up 25 bilingual branches every year, beginning from 2022. Qualified applicants must have scored over 800 points on the TOEIC test or equivalent levels on other tests. There will be a bonus for applicants who pass speaking tests. The world's largest contract electronics producer, Foxconn, announced it will build electric vehicle manufacturing facilities in the US and Thailand next year, as the key iPhone assembler accelerates efforts to catch the rising EV wave to offset the slowing smartphone industry. It plans to begin mass production in the US and Thailand in 2023. Other than in the US and Thailand, Foxconn is also in talks with possible locations in Europe as part of its global EV footprint strategy.
Hello, I'm Wade Lee. Thank you for joining us on this week's Funday News. Here are your top stories. Despite the challenges presented in space technology, Taiwan is going to launch its very first private rocket at the end of this year, taking its first step into the space commercial market. The Taiwanese company T-Space, 晋升 Taikong Keji, will conduct a test flight of its Habit 1 rocket from the Whaler Way Orbit launch complex operated by the Australian company Southern Launch.
Habit 1 is made with 100 domestically sourced components. The name Habit is Saisiat for flying squirrels. The Habit 1 hybrid multifunction sounding rocket is 10 meters in height and 1.5 meters in width and weighs 3 tons. It's a two-stage suborbital rocket. A hybrid rocket is a rocket that uses propellants in two different phases, one solid and the other either gas or liquid. The first launch of the Habit 1 was scheduled for December 27, 2019, but was called off after protests from the local indigenous community in Taidong, Taiwan. But with the blessings of the community, the launch was rescheduled for February 13th, but was cancelled due to bad weather. The scheduled launch that will take place at Whaler's Way Orbital Launch Complex in South Australia in late 2021 will be its third try.
Taiwan's government has taken its first step to develop a domestic space industry, having passed a new Space Development Act earlier this year in May. The Ministry of Science and Technology said the law lays the legal foundation for the further development of Taiwan's space program, which allows for the public sector as well as private enterprise to comply with relevant laws, and encourages the development of forward-looking technologies to enhance the competitiveness of space-related industries.
With the enforcement of the space law, the first commercial space launch company in Taiwan, T-Space, plans two phases of the Habit project. After the Habit 1 suborbital launch, which will be used to validate the vehicle's propulsion, guidance, telemetry, and structure systems, its Habit 5 is scheduled to test as well. Habit 5 is a three-stage orbital rocket in development from the Habit 1. Habit 5 has an approximate height of 20 meters, a diameter of 2.2 meters, and a first stage thrust of 650 kN. The target payload is 390 kg to low Earth orbit and 350 kg to Sun synchronous orbit. It will be T-Space's first commercial rocket. According to media reports, the head of the National Space Organization of Taiwan said Taiwan's government will build a rocket launch site for the long-term development of the country's space program.
La, 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 la.
The iPhone manufacturer Foxconn is expanding its business territory in the electric vehicle industry. By expanding its product line into automobile semiconductors, key components, advanced driving-related software, and EV assembly. Foxconn also set up a software and hardware open platform, the MIH EV Open Platform. This includes a chassis, electric architecture, and support for autonomous driving, which will shorten development time for the automakers, especially newcomers to electric vehicle industry.
Media reports Foxconn has two plants in mind. Its EV Thailand plant will be part of Foxconn's joint venture with Thai oil giant PTT Public Company to develop EV and component production. Planned annual capacity will be around 150,000 to 200,000 e-cars. The U.S. plant will begin building EVs by the end of 2023. Foxconn is in negotiations with three states in the U.S. to build its first EV manufacturing plant in North America, including Wisconsin, which just agreed with Foxconn to amend its former plan of investing $10 billion in the state. The company also announced lately it plans to buy a chip facility from a leading Taiwanese memory chip maker in Hsinchu for $2.52 billion NT dollars as a strategic move to secure a source of semiconductors for its electric vehicle business.
Taiwan has pledged to become a bilingual nation by 2030. Government officials have begun doing their part in contributing to that endeavor. Recently, the Ministry of Culture announced a brand new platform, Taiwan Plus, to promote Taiwan. Private companies also extended their reach to create more opportunities in the diversified multilingual markets. Anna, our correspondent, has more. Anna?
Thanks, Wade. As Taiwan is getting noticed more than ever by all over the world, especially following the Tokyo Olympics, the 2030 bilingual nation target is no longer a vision, but an imminent challenge for Taiwanese. Considering that in the near future, many people will be coming from the US, Europe, and Japan to stay in Taiwan for a longer time after the pandemic, Taiwan's first commercial bank is hiring 115 language talents to staff its 37 bilingual branches it had planned to set up by the end of this year with a monthly salary of 45,000 NT dollars.
First Commercial Bank said as of the end of July, nearly 3,000 of its bank workers, or 38% of its entire staff, had taken the General English Proficiency Test, which is an increase of 16% from last year's 22%. More than 2,000 participants, or over 70%, scored an equivalent of 500 points on the TOEIC test, and 240 participants, or 8%, scored an equivalent of 900 points. The bank will set up 37 bilingual branches by the end of this year, of which nearly 10 will offer Mandarin, English, and Japanese services. The bank plans to set up 25 bilingual branches every year, beginning from 2022. It will also hire a total of 115 language talents this year who must have scored over 800 points on the TOEIC test or equivalent levels on other tests. There will be a bonus for applicants who pass speaking tests.
And that's all the time we have for today. Thank you for joining us on this week's Fun Day News. Let's make every day a fun day. I'm Wei Li, your host, and I will see you next time.